And please tell me whether you are able to see it or not.
Yes, it is visible, sir.
Please tell me about the voice also.
Yes, sir, we are getting the voice too.
Hello viewers, in this topic you will learn about internal academic audit. Let's try to understand the concept of internal academic audit. In the polytechnic, an internal quality assurance cell is constituted which takes care of quality assurance and continuous improvement through systems and processes design and its implementation. It periodically audits the quality of academic activities against the set processes and targets. The members of internal quality assurance cell are trained in quality assurance and assessment. Now, let us have a look on criteria for internal academic audit. For accreditation purpose, the internal quality assurance cell covers all the criteria and sub-criteria mentioned in self-assessment report suggested by NBA. Suggestive format and parameters for conducting academic audit are listed in a specified format. Let's see what it is. The suggestive format could contain name of the program, name of the auditors, audit period, audit dates, and it can be prepared in this format. The first column is serial number. The second column is academic audit parameters, and the third column is actual observation of the team, and the fourth column is remarks. The first criteria may be orientation of the students about the institute and program, including vision, mission, PEOs, POs, and PSOs, quality policy, various rules of statutory body, government, board of technical education, and professional societies, comprehensiveness of the program brochure, quality of academic calendar, adherence to academic calendar, quality of course plan prepared by course teachers for theory as well as practical. The next criteria, quality of implementation of course plan by course teachers for theory as well as practical, quality of industrial training of students, use of student-centric teaching learning methods, use of information communication technology, use of collaborative and blended learning methods, quality of students' project, minor projects as well as major projects, quality of reports and assignments submitted by students, quality of outcome based assessment tools and techniques used by students, quality and comprehensiveness of feedback given to the students for improving learning, quality of laboratory experiments and practice, quality of personality development activities undertaken for the students, quality of entrepreneurship skills development. The next criteria, quality of mentoring, guidance and counseling activities performed for the students, quality of professional society activities performed, quality of quiz, paper presentation, competitions and exhibition organized for the students, quality of interaction with outer world including industry, improvement in course outcome attainment. improvement in POs and PSOs attainment, action taken on feedback of the students, quality of papers in technical magazine, quality of continuing education programs conducted for stakeholders, quality of training of faculty members. The next criteria, improvement in performance and achievement of teachers, improvement in ICT facilities, improvement in laboratory and computer center, improvement in library, quality of lessons in language laboratory, quality of placement efforts, quality of documentation, comprehensiveness of information available to the students and teachers, effectiveness of grievance redressal mechanism. The institute may add few more criteria for academic audit purpose. This format is given to the academic audit team, and the team actually uses it for conducting the academic audit. If some special incidences are noticed, they are recorded under remark column. Now, there could be an obvious question, what should be the frequency of internal audit? The frequency of the internal quality audit varies from polytechnic to polytechnic. If the polytechnic has well established systems and processes and has been performing excellent in the past, the audit period may be yearly. If the polytechnic is establishing outcome based education system and processes and it is not matured, then the audit frequency may be 6 monthly. Let's talk about methodology of audit. Internal quality assurance cell may constitute a team for conducting the academic audit of each program. In this team, there could be 2 to 3 members who are specially trained in conducting the academic audit. The internal quality assurance cell may declare the schedule for academic audit in the institute calendar itself. The detailed schedule is informed in advance to auditors and auditee. The academic audit teams are briefed about the audit procedure, code of conduct, role, and audit report preparation. The audit team conducts the audit against the given criteria and notes down its observation in the given format. It prepares the report and submits it to the internal quality assurance cell for further processing after completion of the audit. After completion of academic audit, a report is prepared by internal quality assurance cell pointing out the strengths, weaknesses, and concerns. It suggests significant actions to be taken to improve the quality of the program as a whole. It may suggest policy guidelines related to specific criteria. It improves the design of quality systems and processes for improving the quality of program as a whole. It also prepares action plan for taking corrective and preventive actions for improving quality of programs as a whole. Let's understand how the records can be maintained. The records of internal academic audit are maintained by internal quality assurance cell. It maintains the records such as audit schedule, audit report, action taken to improve the performance and achievement. So, friends, in this topic, we have learned about concept, purpose, and methods of conducting internal academic audit of the program. Thanks for watching.
Okay. I always say that academic audit brings a spiral effect. It brings positive spiral effect. So, in one cycle, you reach up to a particular level. In other cycle, you improve. So, in this way, it is improving the performance of the institute. And if you do it honestly for 2 years, means if you are able to complete 4 cycles, I can say with guarantee that Everyone in the institute will become confident in implementing and improving the quality of his or her performance. And since the work is done in a team, so the performance of the team or the performance of the department as a whole will also improve. And it is all contextual, so that people will also take interest in it, and people will also be committed for it. So I always say that academic audit brings a spiral effect in our performance, institutional or departmental performance. In NITR Bhopal, we do it every 6 months, and it is all planned and it is all done openly and honestly. It is not like I appreciate you and you appreciate me. No, it is not like, but it is based on the targets and the plans of individuals and of departments. So it is very much useful for us to bring improvement. And I want to share with you that especially at institute level, we are able to take policy decisions. If we find that out of 60 faculty members, 40 faculty members are facing this particular problem, and this requires intervention at institute level, so we design and implement those types of interventions. So this is how we improve the system itself. And after that, we improve the implementation of the system. So I personally find it very useful in bringing improvements right from top to bottom, means right from governance to implementation and enjoying the fruits of the audit. So it is for betterment of the institute as a whole. Okay, I think it is 2:36. So I must take questions on academic audit. Then if you permit, I will talk about remaining parameters of continuous improvement.
At our institution, sir.
Great.
And we are having IQAC, but IQAC we have established in the year 2018, towards the end of 2018, when we actually applied for the NAC. And the visit was about to come, so we were in the first cycle of the NAC, but NBA we are in the third cycle we have cleared.
Great.
So we are having the academic audit cell, and we have this procedure. Definitely the parameters which you have shown us all are not present into that format, and we would try to incorporate as much parameters as you have mentioned into our format also.
Would like to respond to questions of our colleagues,
yes,
faculty
sir.
Participants.
So if anyone is having questions related to the academic audit, so please. I think in the chat box we are not having any question.
Okay, no question. Take care. Now coming, how much time I have, madam? It is 2:30.
Yeah, at three we are having the next.
Okay. So now coming to the next part. So friends, we have realized the importance of conducting academic audit. And if you are more interested in academic audit, you can read my book on academic audit only. I think it is not available on the Google Books free of cost, but you can search it and you can download it.
Many
of my participants tell me about all these things. Otherwise, it is a very cheap book. It is not a costly book. You can purchase it also for your library. Okay, then coming to the improvement in placement, higher studies, and entrepreneurship. So here I would like to focus my discussion on three points. Improvement in placement. If you are having outcome-based philosophy in your institute, definitely your placement will improve. That is one thing. Another thing is that if you are having rope out exercises means you have variety of activities for the students, and most of the activities are well designed and well implemented, then your students will be able to perform better in comparison to students of other institutions. So you must design rope out exercises, and I have seen in most of the institutions it is casually designed and it is implemented by a novice or untrained person. So if you are having group discussion, so you should be trained in organizing the group discussion, in tools and techniques of group discussion, in all the approaches of group discussion like fishbowl approach or sociogram or rubric, observation schedule, like that. So you should be very well versed with all the tools, techniques, and approaches. Open fish bowl, close fish bowl. So all these are the scientific techniques. And many of our friends are not aware about it. So unless you use scientific techniques, you will not be able to develop the ability and confidence in your students. So there's a need to design and implement rope out exercises, and the duration of the rope out exercises may be 7 to 15 days, as I talked about the rope in exercises. So this is found to be very, very useful for getting the placement and for getting better placement. So try to prepare action plan for rope out also. And under that action plan, you can mention about all these things which are the requirement of NBA accreditation also. Then coming to the higher studies. So you can facilitate, you may be having mentoring cell or guidance and counseling cell. So under that umbrella, you can test the personality of the students, you can assess their aptitude, and accordingly you can guide them, and maybe on payment basis you can organize various activities for competing in competitive examinations. So it is not necessary that always you provide everything. You can guide and you can facilitate. But there should not be in between, or broker business in between. So it is between the student and the organization which is providing the service. So you simply bring them on one platform, you don't get into it, and you don't make any profit out of it. So I think it is acceptable to the students, and it is acceptable to you also. Yeah, then coming to the entrepreneurship. Nowadays, this is becoming very, very important. And Government of India and the society wants that innovative and creative people should come in business. And that is why you need to develop entrepreneurs also. And I have seen in many institutions only activities are conducted, and most of the activities are conducted casually. So suppose they have conducted 15 activities, but at the end there is nothing. So I would request the entrepreneurship development cell to come out with the professionally prepared action plan. And suppose you are having a batch of 60 students, so you organize the activities in such a way so that at the end of the last activity, your students are having business plan. So maybe 10% or 15% students are having business plan. So before they pass out, at least they have a project proposal, they have a business plan. So out of say 15% students, say even if 5% students turn up, I think it is a great achievement for the institute. So it should be done properly in a design manner, and at the end there should be, means some students should have concrete business plan to set up their enterprise. So this is what I want to share related to this particular parameter 7.3, and then coming to 7.4, that is improvement in the quality of students admitted to the program. Actually it is fact based, so you can't do anything. It is before their, means these achievements are before their entry to the institute. So you have to simply put the data in criterion 3 and you have to bring those data here, not criterion 3, I think some other criteria. So you simply bring those data here and you can't do much related to this. So this is what all about continuous improvement. There are some points for the first year also. So whatever I have talked, that is applicable for improvement in first year courses also, and improvement in attainment of PO and PSOs, which are aligned to first year courses. So this is what I wanted to share with you in the limited time. If you want, still there is any question, I would be happy to respond to your question. But before that, I want to refer the evaluation guideline also. If you look at the evaluation guideline for criterion 7, because this is the Bible or this is the model answer for all of us. So we should always keep in mind the evaluation guideline. I am just sharing it with you. Criterion 7. I am just sharing the evaluation guideline for criterion 7. Yeah, I think you are able to see it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
If you look at the evaluation guideline, documentation of PO and PSO attainment level, 5 points are there. Identification of gaps and shortfalls, 5 points are there. So gaps doesn't mean you set the target 2 and you have achieved 1.85. That is not the gap. What is the real gap, whether it is in curriculum or curriculum implementation or methodology or like that. Then plan of action to bridge the gap and its implementation. So you need to keep record of previous 3 years and you need to prepare the action for the next year also. So you cannot camouflage or you cannot befool the team. So you, even what I want to say, if you don't have the system, you will not get these points. Similarly, assessment shall be based on conduct of action taken in relation to continuous improvement. So whatever, as I shared the example of my institute, we design policy interventions, we provide resources like that, like that. So if you don't take actions right from governance to implementation level, you won't get points for academic audit. What we have seen, there are many institutions, whenever I go for visit, I see that IQAC is there, format is there, which has been downloaded from some other institute. Even they have not removed the name of that institute. And for the namesake, they have conducted the academic audit, but they have not compiled the data. They have not designed any intervention based on that. So I have seen all such cases, and the institute wants to claim 10 points too. So who will give them points? Okay, so all types of evidences should be there. right from design to implementation related to intervention. And I think this is very clear and specific for rest of the parameters. So these are the things you need to show to visiting team. Okay. Now coming to your questions. Any question? It's surprising that 95 participants are there and I'm not having any question. Whenever I go for training, I grill the trainer like anything. I don't tease, but yes, yeah.
In the chat box, I think Vyas sir, Kaval K. Vyas sir has asked when we are taking this academic audit as a regular habit, so would it be taking some useful time of regular academics? So,
no, it can be properly designed and let it be in what we do in our institute, everybody is involved in academic audit. So it is a learning exercise and improvement exercise for all of us. We learn through others' performance and we learn through observations also, and we learn through mistakes which are committed by others also. So what we have seen, whenever I do academic audit of some other department or other program or other faculty member, so I learn many things. And when I become auditee, maybe after 3 days, so I take care of all those things. So this is how it is a continuous learning process for all of us. Ji.
Yeah. Yes.
So yes, it takes time, but if you properly design it, it will not take more than 3 hours of individuals.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Exercise or appreciating each other exercise. It has to be honest.
Actually, when the academic audit, we used to start in a department or the institution, initial resistance is there. And it is, yes. I think, it is very natural. So if it has been overcome, after some time, it becomes a regular feature of the institution. And then even after some time, faculty used to appreciate it because all the documents are organized at the time of internal academic audit and when the institute or department is actually undergoing the process of NBA accreditation or NAC accreditation. At that time, they need not to search here and there where this document is because everything is organized within a semester. So later on, because we have traveled a lot into it, and now we are saying that the faculty members are now appreciating that the academic audit is a good feature of the institute.
Yeah.
So it is a personal experience which we have felt here.
True.
So thank you very much, sir.
Let me summarize.
Sure.
Summarization is very,
yes,
very important.
Very essential.
Yeah,
yes.
So let me summarize our learning. We started with the effective way of filling the self-assessment report. And I told you that it is not the filling of self-assessment report, but it is the implementation of quality education in the context of NBA accreditation and in the context of outcome-based education and in the context of our achievements at institute level, department level, and individual levels. So that is prerequisite. After that, we talked about the pre-qualifiers, we must satisfy the pre-qualifiers requirement of NBA for our program. Then we started talking about the filling the self-assessment report. And we have appreciated that since we are not implementing the outcome-based education in our institute in letter and spirit, so let it be 1 year cycle and let everyone must have hands-on experiences of designing and implementing the system, quality by design, so that we are able to create adequate and necessary evidences, and we are able to achieve the things which are expected by NBA. After that, we have discussed the criterion one of self-assessment report, and we have also discussed about the evaluation guidelines related to criterion one. Then we move to the criterion two, which is very important, and all faculty members have significant role to play for criterion two. And we have appreciated that every teacher must prepare the course plan from outcome-based education point of view and must implement it effectively and efficiently. And we should try to use student-centric teaching learning methods, and we should try to bring world of work situation in our campus. That was the learning of yesterday. And we have talked about many principles like say, do, prove, improve, like quality by design, like quality is responsibility of all. We should work in a team. We should try to prevent problems. We should try to bring continuous improvement. And today, we have specifically discussed two things. One is related to improvement in PO and PSO. And if it is not there, we should try to analyze the problem or causes. And then we should prepare the actions. These actions should be prepared PO-wise and PSO-wise, so that we can implement it effectively and efficiently. Means we can ask all course teachers to do it effectively and efficiently. After that, we have discussed about the academic audit, and the whole academic audit is the hope, the purpose of whole academic audit is to assure the quality and to bring a spiral effect in performance of the institute, performance of the department, and performance of the program as a whole in totality. So quality is seen in totality. So with these concluding remarks, I want to thank the sponsoring agency, the host institute, and all fellow professionals for providing me an opportunity to share my experiences with all of you. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable insights that you have given us in two sessions. We have learned a lot, not about the subject matter. Yesterday also, I complimented you on the same, that how beautifully a session can be arranged. That is also what we have learned from you. You have very good command over the subject matter because you are an expert on it. But apart from that, we learned so many things, patience, everything we have learned from you, sir. So I am very thankful to you, sir, for your valuable time, concern, and insights on the subject, and for all the participants of this FTP. So I'm truly grateful to you, sir, on the behalf of management, organizing team, on the behalf of sponsoring agency, that is Rajasthan Technical University, on the behalf of all the participants, and on my personal behalf. So I'm very grateful to you, sir, for your time, for your concern, and for sharing your valuable insight with us. Thank you so much. Any participant, any participant wish to speak something to sir, please. there are many comments in the chat box, you can see, but if some participant wish to ask,
yeah, wants to share feelings, yeah,
yes, please,
if time permits.
Yes, Nitesh Indoria, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. I am actually Professor S.K. Sharma, Director, MIT RC College, Alwar. I am very thankful to enlightening in this NBA workshop, FDP. Really, I am very appreciating all the great speakers, very learned speakers, very highly experienced professors. And it's a very nice, and I am thankful to the TQube, RTU, and JIT, this team who organized this wild show. Really, from the criteria, every details of each criteria we have discussed, guideline by the NBA, very transparent, they have discussed and guide us. Even though we are not taught, we are not in touch every time, all these aspect, but you clarify each and every point, very transparency in the system. And if honestly any institution want to go through, he can just go read and one by one and prepare the documents and motivate the team, entire team. The quality is not by chance. Quality is, yes,
design.
Yes, sir. So I am very thankful to all of you. Really, I appreciate Ankit sir, who always taking care of all the participants who are joining, not joining, assignment, other things. And thank you, Kusum ma'am. And thank you, Gupta sir, and entire team of GIT, who constantly involved to organize this beautiful workshop, FDP.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. It's my
thank favorite. You, Sharma,
sir. Thank you.
So, I think sir has shared his sentiments. Thank you very much, sir. We are honored and we are very motivated by your words. These words actually works. So, sir, we are now starting with the proceedings. So, thank you once again, sir, for being with us. So now we are going to start with the proceedings of the valedictory. So it is a session of all the participants. You have listened us for 9 sessions, so now it is time for you to speak about. I think Sharma sir has already started it, and I would like to invite Dr. Vikas Mishra, Director GITS from Udaipur, for sharing his feedback on the workshop. Dr. Vikas Mishra. Sir, are you here?
Yes, ma'am. Just give me a moment.
Yeah, sure, please.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Kusum, ma'am. Thank you for inviting me to share my inputs. First of all, good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I would like to congratulate the entire team of Jeet Jodhpur, the coordinator Kusum Agarwal ma'am, for organizing such a wonderful, very knowledgeable FDP on a very relevant topic. And just Ankit, just one of your faculty, Ankit, just probably around an hour back has just called me, and he has been a very good colleague of us. We share a very
Thank
good.
You, sir.
We so share much, a very good bonding, and he's a very excellent faculty, so I couldn't say no to him. The topic itself is very relevant, as we all are aware. The talks or the deliberations which were carried out were very knowledgeable, were very giving a deep insight of the topic. And personally, I believe that OBE or NBA accreditation, if we start following the norms, they all are a step towards an academic excellence. So as an academic fraternity, if we start following these things, rather what personally I feel that most of the institutes, we are taking it as a type of a boundary condition that we have to implement it. If we see these as a guiding tool, that they are guiding us towards achieving the academic excellence then obviously accreditation or excellence will automatically follow, which JEET is a classical example. I congratulate for being Thanks. Having this the autonomous status. That discussions and that experts sessions which were carried out for last 3 days, I was also fortunate enough to attend this, although to be very honest confession that I was not able to focus continuously because of the administrative responsibilities also which were going side by side. But yes, I was keeping a track and I was continuously there. The session was very deep insight, and my congratulations to entire team. Thank you, Kusum ma'am, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you to Ankit also for remembering me. Very good colleague again.
No, sir.
And my best thank wishes. So my best wishes to entire team. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for the kind words and blessings. Sir, if you have something which can be improved on these programs for future, please mention when you are giving the feedback. This is one thing which I would like to mention. Now I would like to invite Dr. Anita Alaria, Associate Professor from Purnima University. Ma'am, are you here?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Yes, please.
Am I audible?
Ma'am, your voice is low, actually.
Now, am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Respected Dr. Ari Gupta, sir, Vice Chancellor, RTU. Dr. Dhirendra Mathur, sir, Coordinator, RTU. Sandeep Mehta, sir, Dean, Engineering, JEET. Navneet Agarwal, sir. Dr. Kusum Lata Agarwal, ma'am. Ankit Tandon, sir. Dignitaries, renowned faculties, experts, and all faculty members of JEET, and all the participants, a very good afternoon to all. This 3-day FTP on accreditation, a tool for continuous improvement, was a wonderful learning experience and a great achievement with innovative learning outcomes. This FTP was a tool for learning about accreditation, assessments, methodology, benefits, and objective-based education. Here we try to cover all the parameters required for accreditation, which helps an institute for quality benchmarking. As it is clear that NBA accredits program, not institute. So it is mandatory to continue the rhythm of making new programs with innovative ideas, new techniques, and program educational objectives. Here we also learned how to prepare an effective self-assessment report, that is SAR, guided by Dr. B.L. Mehta, sir. The module continued with the informative topics by Dr. S.K. Mandal, sir, on assessment and evaluation. So it is time to rethink and restructure teaching and learning, coupled with new approaches to evaluation and professional development for faculty. We also learned the implementation of outcomes-based education through open source, that is Moodle, by Dr. Anand Bevre, sir, and Dr. Vinay Kulkarni, sir. Moodle, a digital platform on which the teacher and student can share and learn concepts. This is a unique digital classroom which provides abundant applications like presentation, quiz, reports, activities, and many more. So we are very much thankful to all the dignitaries and experts who could find out time of their busy schedule to enlighten us. Many thanks to JEET, its faculty members, and IT team who have played a pivotal role in coordinating the session during the tenure of last 3 days, and especially in this rampant COVID crisis across the globe. Now, I would like to give a special thank to Dr. Kusum Agarwal, ma'am, and Ankit Tandon, sir, who were having one-to-one contact with each and every participant for the last 3 days and making this program a big successful. So thank you once again. Thank you, JEET. Jai Hind. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
For your kind words. So in the series, I would like to invite Dr. Anil Dhawan, Professor and Head Department of Applied Science at Anand International College of Engineering, Jaipur. Yes, sir, please.
Thank you, ma'am. A very good afternoon to all of you. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon to all of you. Thank you so much, first of all. I'd like to thank the host institute I'm very much thankful to them for organizing such a important some webinar on a particular topic of accreditation, a tool for continuous improvement. So I would like to just give my views that I'm really thankful to the speakers. I can see that there are very learned people over here. Dr. R.P. Dahiya sir was there on the very first day, and he has given a very good explanation about the NPA accreditation part. Assessment part was also discussed in brief. So I can say this, these things will go to help everyone, you know, who are thinking for this NBA part. They're definitely going to help them, and definitely we are looking for that. So that will be very useful for us also. In fact, S.K. Das sir has taken all the important aspects of assessment part, evaluation, along with the attainment and learning part. So that was really helpful for everyone to understand each and every aspects of NBA part. And as far as the remaining speakers were concerned, I can see that all of them are very, very good speakers, and they have taken all the part very, very importantly. And I can see that B.J. Mehta sir was also there from SVIIT Surat, and he has given a very clear understanding about the preparing the effective self-assessment part. That was very important aspect of the NBA part. And in fact, B.L. Gupta sir, you know, I can see him, he was continuously speaking on the topics, and he has taken all the aspects of the this NBA part and in very detail. That I agree to the Kusum ma'am that he has taken a very, very clear indication about each and every topics what has to be taken for. So I really appreciate all the speaker. In fact, Anand Bevar sir was there from Cummins College Pune. He has taken all about the Moodle part. That was also very important to in taking these things. So as a whole, I can see that all the speakers along with your host institute and RTU and TechCube, and they have taken a very good initiative in organizing such a good event. And I'm really thankful to you, Ankit and Kusumayam, for giving me the opportunity to be a part of this event. And really, I like to have more and more event like that in the coming days. Thank you so much from my side.
Thank you, Dhawan sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dhawan sir. So in the continuation, I would like to invite Dr. Jitendra Srimali, Professor Computer Science and Engineering, Techno India, NJR College, Udaipur. Sir, are you here? Dr. Jitendra Srimali, sir.
Can you hear me, madam?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon to you, madam. Thank you to the institute for this fantastic initiative that you have taken. And but I would be failing in my duty if I did not start with thanking Professor Gupta. He has given us so much time. He devoted a lot of time earlier, and today also he has spoken so much about the quality initiatives and their role, and how important it is in to, you know, continuously improve your performance. I mean, it is not necessary that every institute is equally well equipped. Therefore, it is inevitable that they will start at different levels. What is very important is that spirit of continuous improvement, where you follow a pattern, follow a structured approach that is being recommended by the accreditation body, and based on that approach, grow continuously so that you develop as an institute and your reputation grows. This is the message that came out from today's session, which is the key to long-term sustenance for any college. And your earlier session also was very, very informative, sir. In fact, listening to you, I really wish we were in a classroom where we could, you know, approach you personally and talk to you and get draw more from your experience and also learn from the other colleagues. But the whole initiative taken by the college from Jodhpur has been phenomenal. It has generated a lot of discussions, and we are extremely grateful to you for your time, sir, and to the institute for organizing something like this. Dr. Kusum Agrawal and Professor Ankit Tandon, thank you very much for your initiative.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
We are truly honored to have you all as a participant in our FTP. So it is a kind of privilege on our part too, sir, that we are having such a renowned participants in our FTP. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Now I would like to invite one more feedback. Professor Anjali Dabai, head of the department English in the Gitanjali Institute of Technology, AITS. Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Am I audible to you?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Okay. First of all, greetings to all the respected dignitaries, to the members, and to the team. And congratulations to the Institute and to the team for conducting such a nice FDP on this topic, that is NBA. It was really very informative. It gave me a framework for what I already do. Besides, I've learned a great deal also. The FDP was really very well executed, and the experts were also very good. Actually, it was all very informative. And because our college is also going for this NBA process, so some of the points that were having doubts in our mind, it were very clear to me. Actually, I was having some of my classes. I was indulged in my online classes. But then too, I made out time for joining these sessions, and it really helped me out a lot. So I think I should say thank you to Ankit also, because he has been a friend of mine. And because Ankit has shared this link with me. And thank you, Ankit. Thank you very much. And thank you, Kusum ma'am. You have been a very good spokesperson. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Ashni ma'am, for the kind words.
Thank you, ma'am. So these are some, yes, there is one more, which is Professor Dr. Abhijit Kulshrest from our own institution. So I would like to invite him for his feedback, sir. Sir, are you here? Abhijit, sir, can you listen me? I think he is not here.
I think he is busy in the meeting, ma'am. So
okay, no issues. If any participant would like to give his feedback, the forum is open. Participant can unmute themselves and give their feedbacks. So session is open to you all. These were some who has requested us, or we have approached them for giving the feedback. So now the forum is open for giving the feedbacks to for all the participants. Please, it is over to you, all the participants. Yes. Any feedback on the part of improvement? Because I'm mostly looking towards the scope of improvement. Yes, yes. Kuldeep Sharma, sir, would you like to share something?
Thank you, madam. Okay, very good session, very good MVP. I enjoyed it and learned a lot. And I hope the institution will also start accreditation process from this month, September itself. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Ma'am, I want to share a thing with you.
Yes,
that Kuldeep Sharma, sir, have joined this FTP from Jammu. And there is a network issue in Jammu, but still, sir is trying to continuously attend all the sessions. And
That's great. I was also even not knowing this, that Kuldeep Sharma sir is talking from Jammu.
Yeah,
thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
I have a colleague in your institute who remained in our institute for some years. Head civil engineering department.
Yes, Arvind.
I joined because of you. Send me the link and away.
Thank you, sir. So kind of you. Thank you. Any other participant would like to speak something? I would like to request all the participants to switch on their cameras, but switch off their mic at the same time for the group photograph. And even then, you have something in your mind to share with us, please do post us. We are very happy to listen to you through your mails, through your messages, or through any other media. So now I am officially closing this ceremony, valedictory ceremony. Your certificates would be dispatched in the e-mode at your email IDs. So very soon we would be posting all your certificates to your registered email IDs. So please switch on your cameras and switch off your mic, please. Ankit, you may proceed now.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Group photograph is taken from my side, and I think my voice is not.
you are audible, Ankit, and I have already announced about the group photograph.
Yeah, ma'am, group photograph is already taken from my side, and now I am really thankful to all the participants and all the dignitaries present in the validity session. And with my single request, Director Sir from Gitanjali Institute, Director Sir from MITR Institute, Dhawan Sir, and Anita Ma'am, all gave a very good feedback to us. Really thank you to all the participants and experts, BL Gupta Sir, RP Daya Sir, NITR, RP Daya Sir, then after SK Das Mandal Sir have joined for the three sessions. So thanks to all the participants, all the dignitaries, and last but not the least, I would like to thank Kusum Ma'am as well, who trusted me to that. I am completely free from her side. When I discussed the thing with Kusum Ma'am, that Kusum Ma'am told me that yes, Ankit, be on your own part. She trusted me a lot to organize such a nice FDP. Under your guidance, we will organize more events in our department, in our institute. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thanks.
So thank you all the participants, and you have been very kind to us, very cooperative for all the sessions, although we were conducting on Google Meet, where many times problems arises because we don't have much control on the participants' mics and cameras. So even then, I feel that you are the most disciplined participants I can ever have. So thank you so much, and have a nice day. Thank you.
Thank you very much, madam. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.